Hey, I'm Pete. I'm the lead singer of Stereo Honey.
And I'm Gat Moth, the director of their latest video for Don't Speak. We've just finished burning the piano.
Yes, we have.
Nothing went wrong yet.
Well, we almost set fire to one of our crew. Well, he almost set fire to himself, to be fair.
Yeah, he did.
Fucking hell!
Fucking hell!
But it was quite funny and enjoyable.
Yeah. Yeah, boy!
Yeah,
it's
Yeah, so we met
Amira,
where we were supporting the Amazons, and they were playing a gig for War Child. You know, I'd had a chance to kind of look at some of your work before we did that gig, you know. And I think, like, you know, for us, like the lads, we were kind of like, you know, when you're starting out as a band, like aligning yourself with creative people who've got the same vision as you and, like, are really hungry and talented, is just, you know, you got to find those people. Yeah. And I think we felt really lucky, you know, to have met you know, through the Amazons boys, and, you know, felt really privileged to work with you. Calling all the lonely till the end. All the walls you're pushing off. The song is told from depression's point of view. So the chorus, you know, don't speak, don't think, don't listen, I'll keep your still heart beating, and every time you give a little away. It's the idea of living with mental health issues sort of plucks away at your life force, but sort of keeps you going, but barely. And so we had this idea of like a dilapidated house and like filling it with you know, references to like the themes of the video.
Yeah, exactly. That was where water came into play.
Yeah,
you made a good point with the water and how like something like depression or mental illness can weigh a person down.
Yeah,
and we've kind of played on that.
I think that was it though. Like the you know, for me, the image you showed me struck me because I suppose the song. It's kind of really about stasis, the way that like mental health issues, as you said, like weighs a person down and keeps them from doing what they want to do. And I don't think there's a better like visual analogy for that than someone literally stuck in a piano. And then your idea was like, okay, well, what if the, you know, the force in the piano is depression itself,
and it's
coming
linked,
out, it's like rearing its head.
Yeah, it's linked to the music. I think that's the cool thing, because with filmmaking and art and stuff, I like the idea of playing on, like, I don't know, just putting a twist in things, and that's kind of the idea of this.
Almost a snake charmer coaxing a snake
out
of its
box. That was the phrase, wasn't it?
Yeah. Right?
Yeah.
So it's kind of like, you know, what if the subject of the music video is like coaxing the spirit of depression out of the piano by playing it. Fire that starts inside your head. It burns but never leaves. Now, but it's pretty cool, you know, taking something from like an image you found on the internet to like realizing the entire video. You know, we worked so hard, like, you know, building this piano from scratch. Like, I don't think anyone has ever, I mean, correct me if I'm wrong, I'm sure maybe someone's done it, but has anybody ever, I don't think anyone to my knowledge has ever ripped open a grand piano, watertighted it, filled it with water, film someone dancing in it and then set it on fire.
Yeah, I think
so. It was quite like, it was quite a feat.
That's the thing. There was no step by step process.
No. So we were like searching YouTube for like how to take apart a grand piano, and all the videos we were watching were like how to put a grand piano together. So we ended up watching them backwards.
Watching them in reverse. Yeah, and they just messed with our minds until we just sat there in the garage like 3 in the morning. Like, why have we set out to do this? But that was the kind of, that was cool. We kept going.
So we basically got it ready, 3 o'clock in the morning?
Yeah, pretty much. We picked up the piano from London. It was 3 days construction. And then, the night before, I remember quite vividly, final preparations of like the lining it, making sure a piano can hold liquid and hold water, all of that with it. And Matt, Matt and Ed, who helped build the piano, got like a, they slept on the sofa, and literally 2 hours went by, and then boom, we were off, 5 in the morning, and it was go, go, go. We just filled the van with stuff and drove into London.
Rocked up to the shoot. Yeah. On no sleep.
Yeah.
Yeah, oh, that's better, yeah.
Slide your hand round. Exactly, yeah, and slide it for us. Thumbs up as soon as the music starts, and we're trapped.
Is that wide enough for you? Like a midpoint? That's cool.
That's cool. Nice work. Fire
stars inside you. Beautiful.
Yes. Cut! That was fucking fantastic.
You know, music video. Is like this a really important asset to a band's creativity. It's like, you know, a visual aid to the music. You know, just think about, like, I don't know, the video for Childish Gambino's latest single.
Yeah, it was the video that blew up this.
It's, like, I mean, like, the song in and of itself is great, but, like, you know, you watch it with the music video alongside it, it's just a totalizing piece of art, right? And I think, you know, I speak on behalf of all the lads when I say, like, you know, we wanted to both make music and make videos that were really powerful. And so, you know, I'm very grateful to have met a kindred creative spirit.
It's been a pleasure, man. Yeah, it's been great.
Absolutely.
It's been, the whole project's been wild.
Yeah, it's been fucking nice.
Yeah, I mean, that's like half an hour, so.
And that's a wrap!
Oh, that's 20 minutes.
And that.
Yeah, we'll get some out of that.
That's a wrap!
Sweet, you happy with that?
That's a wrap!